Hello everyone, welcome to the next class on the optimization technique. In this lecture we will see what is the quadratic function and how we can check that function is the positive definite, negative definite or the indefinite. Myself Dr. Garg, working in the School of Mathematics, Thapar Institute, India. You can contact me either of my email IDs if there is any doubt related to optimization technique. So first of all, what we discuss about that, what is a nonlinear programming problem? So a general nonlinear programming problem is defined by using this equation number 1, in which f of x is called as the objective function and g is called as the constant. And if either of the function like f of x or at least one of the constant is nonlinear is there, then we call as this is a nonlinear programming problem. Otherwise we call as the linear programming problem. For example, look at that, this is the objective function, and since objective function, this x1 square plus x2 square and so on is a nonlinear. On the other hand, the constant is my linear, but at least one of them is a nonlinear, so we call as this as nonlinear programming problem. Similarly, look at the second example. In this case, objective function is my linear, but the one of the constant is the nonlinear, so therefore this is also be a nonlinear programming problem. The third example is that in this case, objective function as well as the constant both are the nonlinear, so this is also called as the nonlinear programming problem. Now what is the quadratic form or the quadratic function is that, all of you know that what is the quadratic function, anything which is of the degree 2 is called as the quadratic function. So this is the n variable and each have the degree 2 is called as the quadratic function, or we call as the quadric form in the n variable. Or in general, if we consider as a three-dimension variable, so say x1 plus 2x2 square plus x3 square plus x1, x2 plus x3 plus 7, this is also called as the quadratic because the degree is my 2. Now since any of, or you can say these are the certain examples are there. So you can see that these are the quadratic functions. So we can express any of each of these functions in term of this vector. What is the capital T is represent for my transpose. Capital X is my vector quantity like x1, x2 and so on up to the xn of dimension n. And capital A is my real matrix as well as the symmetric is there. So for each of the problem like say this, we our task is to represent x transpose A of x. But the major question arises is what is the size of this matrix A. So the size of this matrix A is as of the dimension. For example, and this is the rule where you can, how you can find the value of the A, capital A is because A is the matrix. So the elements are A11, A12 and so on. And each of the elements are found by this. So I will tell you how you can find in a easier manner. So first of all, what is the size of the matrix A? Our task is to write like this. What is the dimension of the problem is? How many capital X is? So that is a three-dimensional problem, x1, x2, x3. So there's the size of the A will be my 3 cross 3. Look at that. Now how you can find that? Firstly, the easier way is that, look at the first element is A11. So always remember the subscript represent for the x1, x1, that is x1 square. So what is the coefficient of the x1 square is? 1. So the first element is my 1. Similarly, you can find the diagonal entries. Firstly, what is the coefficient of the x2 square is? Minus 2. What is the coefficient of the x3 square is? 0. Now, since it is a symmetric matrix, so whatever I have written here, this is same as that of this. So the element of this is my 1, 2. So what is the element of the 1, 2 means? X1, x2. What is the coefficient of the x1, x2? 1. So you can take half of whatever here and half is here. Similarly, if you find to find this element, what is that? This is 2, 3. What is the coefficient of the x2, x3 is? Minus of 2. So this element will be half of them, minus 1, minus 1. That is the working rule here. So based on this, you can easily define like this way. So again, you can check this is the 1 coefficient of x1 square, coefficient of the x2 square, x3 square. What is that? This is 1, 3. x1, x3, half of the x1, x3 is 5 by 2, 5 by 2. On the other end, if you just try to like this way, so what is that? There are the three dimensions. So what is the coefficient of the x1 square is minus 3. Coefficient of the x2 square is 2, minus 3. What is the coefficient of the x1, x2? 0, 0 and all others are 0. Similarly, you can write this function. What is the quadratic form is? Here. What is the dimension of the problem is? 2, x1 and x2. So you can write like this way. Because x1 square is my 1, x2 square is my 0 and so on. And since this part will also be there, this is a linear part, so I can express this as x1, x2. What is the coefficient of the x1 is 1, this is minus of 2. Now, once you are writing any of the quadratic function is of the form x transpose of ax, then we can say what is the nature of this quadratic function. It can be the positive or negative is there. So, when it's said to be the positive definite, when the function f of x is always be greater than 0 for all non-zero x. And the meaning of the semi means if at least one of the value, which is a non-zero value of x for which the function is 0. For example, if I say, can this function be always be the positive value? Yes, because it's a quadratic, so it can't be negative. So that's why it's a positive quantity. So since this is always be greater than 0 for all x which are non-zero. On the other hand, if I just consider this example, can this function be always be the positive? Yes. Okay, so it is always positive for all the values of x. Can this function f of x is 0 for all x which are non-zero or at least one of the x? Yes, you can easily find that this is a 0, 2, 0. If you substitute the value of x1, 0, x2, 0, then it is a 0 also. Now, since is equality be there, so equality means this is semi-definite. And in this case, you can see, can you find any of the value for which f of x is 0? No. Because the value of the fx is 0 only for the pair 0, 0, 0. But we need at least one which is non-zero. So this is the definition of the positive and the positive semi-definite. Similarly, you can define the negative definite. Just take the opposite sign. This is less than. Semi means this is less than or equal to. At least one is a non-zero x per day. The third one is the indefinite. That is a function which is neither the positive definite nor the negative definite is called as indefinite. Look at that, this function. Can this function be always be the positive value or always be the negative? You can't say that because if you take the pair 1, 1, it is a negative. If you take the pair 3, minus 1, it's a positive. So it appears both positive and negative. So that's why we call it as the indefinite. But it's not always easy task for us to identify always to check the definites of the matrix quickly. For example, can you say this function is always be greater than 0 or less than 0? You can't say that exactly. So for them, for solving such type of the problems, we will state some simple test of the definiteness, and that is called as the matrix minor test and the eigenvalue test. So there are the two different methods. You can apply either of them. And definitely, the definiteness of the function f of x depending upon the nature of this capital A, because capital X is nothing but the variable speed. So we will discuss the two methods one by one. So firstly, first method is the matrix minor. So all of you know that this is the minor. You may remember that how you calculate the minor when you calculate the A inverse, adjoint of A divided by A. So in order to calculate the adjoint, you always use the minor. But in this case, if I say this is my matrix A, so my task is to construct the principal minors. So what is the principal minor is? What is the size of this A is? 3 cross 3. So it means there are the three principal minors are there. There are the three principal minors, whatever the size is there. What is the D1 is? You have to construct a 1 cross 1 matrix in which the first diagonal entries must be there. That is A11. D2 means that the second principal minor means you have to construct the 2 cross 2 matrix in which the first two diagonal entries must be there. The first two diagonal entries must be there. So what is the other one is A21, A12. Although this is also be the 2 cross 2 matrix, but it does not consist of the first two diagonal entries. So the principal matrix minor means any submatrix of order M which contains first M elements of the principal diagonal. So look at that. The first one is the determinant of this. D2 means that is a 2 cross 2 matrix of this. And what about the D3 is? That's the itself is there. So based on this determinant, it can be the positive value or it can be the negative. Again, if you calculate the determinant of this, it can be the positive or negative. Based on this, we can define the nature of this quadratic function. So what are those are there? So any function f of v task is to firstly calculate A. When it's said to be the positive definite, if all the principal minors d1, d2, d3 and so on, if all are positive, then we call as the positive definite. And when it's semi means that's equality 0. So if apart from the first principal minor, if first of all it's a positive, so all r must be the greater than sign. Semi means if at least one of the principal minors is zero, provided I is not equal to 1. So at least one of the principal minor must be a zero. Negative definite means if all signs are alternative signs, but make sure that the first principal minor must be a negative. So it means the first one is negative, then positive, then negative, and so on. What is the meaning of the semi? Semi means that is the equality. First one should be a negative, and the other one is the opposite sign. It may be at least one of them will be a zero. So then we call as the negative semi. And all those other cases which does not satisfy them, what is the other cases is, if I say first one is negative, second one is negative, third one is negative, and so on. So is there any case satisfy them? No. So such type of the case is called as the indefinite. Another case also be there, if I say the first principal minor is zero. So look at that, in all these four cases, first principal minor need not be a zero. So if first principal minor is zero, then again it is a positive, it's an indefinite. Also, if I say the first minor is positive, second is less than zero, third one is greater than zero, that is alternating sign. But alternating sign means the first one should be a negative. So again, this one not satisfy any one of them. So it will be a indefinite. So this is the matrix minor. On the other hand, if you want to calculate the eigenvalue, what you can do is, you can calculate the eigenvalue of the matrix A, I call as lambda I. Then we will discuss the nature of them based on this eigenvalue. So as the name suggests, the positive definite. If all the eigenvalues are positive, strictly positive, then we call as the positive definite. If at least one of the eigenvalues is zero and other all are positive, then we call as the positive semi. Similarly for the negative, if all are negative and at least one of them is zero and all others are negative, we call as negative semi-definite. And what is the opposite of them is, if some are positive and some are negative, then we call as the indefinite one. So look at the one example. We will discuss certain examples related to them. So first of all, you can't say that x transpose of ax is always greater than 0 by trivially. So how you can see, you can firstly construct the matrix. You can see how you can construct the matrix. What is the coefficient of the x1 square is -3. Coefficient of the x2 square is 2. x3 is -3. This is x1, x2. So take the half of this, -5, -5. x2, x3, half of them, 2 and 2. And now this is the real and the symmetric matrix. Now you can apply either the eigenvalue or the matrix test. So I can apply the matrix test firstly. So what is the, since it is a 3 cross 3, so you can calculate the 3 principal minor. What is the first principal minor is, which consists of the first principal diagonal entries, that is a -3. What is the second is, you can calculate the determinant of second 2 cross 2 matrix in which contains the first 2 diagonal entries here. And you can see the third one is the itself here. So what is the determinant of this is nothing but my -3, which is less than 0. What is the determinant of this is, you can calculate here. So what is that? First principal minor is less than 0. Second principal minor is again less than 0. Third principal minor is greater than 0. They are not alternating sign. Therefore, what is the nature of them is, it is a indefinite. Also, you can, this is the way you can check the definiteness of this. Also, if you want to calculate the eigenvalues are there, so it may be some positive and some negative, so that's why these are indefinite. Look at one more example. Discuss the definiteness of the function here. So you firstly construct the matrix. Look at that, this is the quadratic part. So how you can write the quadratic term is -1 and x2 -1 and all others are 0. And this part is corresponding to the linear. This is 2, 3, x1, x2, and this is the constant part. Now I can apply the matrix test as well as the eigenvalue on this matrix A. This is my A. So what is the principal, what is the diagonal entries of this? What is the principal minor of this? The first one is -1. Second one is here. So what is the determinant of first one is -1. What is the determinant of here is +1. So you can say first one is negative, second one is positive. That is opposite sign. Make sure the first one is a negative. So it means this is a negative definite. On the other hand, if you calculate the eigenvalue of this, what are the eigenvalues of this? This is nothing but my -1 and -1. Both are negative. So it is a negative definite. So look at that. This is not be the semi because none of them is a zero. So both have you get the same result. You can apply either of them. Look at one more example is there. Check the definiteness of the function here. So if you want to calculate the firstly matrix, either use this or this. So what is that? Is it true? This is a 1, this is minus 2, and so on. So what is the, there are the 2 cross 2 matrix. So you have to calculate firstly the D1 and D2. What is the first principal minor is 1. What is the second principal minor is? That is a 2 cross 2 which consists of the 2 diagonal entries. So that is a minus of 2. First one is the positive, second one is the negative. So what is that? This is nothing. It's an indefinite. Because once it's a positive, then all are positive. If they are alternative sign, the first one must be the negative. On the other hand, what are the eigenvalues of this? It is 1 and minus of 2, which are positive as well as negative both. So therefore, you can say this is a indefinite. That is neither the positive definite nor the negative definite. Can you find the quadratic form of this? Since it is not the quadratic function, so you can't able to write the quadratic function of the form x transpose of ax. Then how you check the definiteness of this? So therefore you are unable to write the matrix A from this. So how you can check the definiteness of such type of the function? For this we need another concept called as the Hessian matrix that we will see in our next class. But make sure that before that you must understand or revise the lecture like x transpose A, when the positive definite and when the negative definite. So that's the today's lecture is here. We will see in the next class on the Hessian matrix. Till then, you can simply browse this link for find the other videos related to the optimization techniques. Till then, best of luck students. Happy learning.